During an inventory count, you and your staff count and record each item in your store. It is recommended in Vend to perform your inventory count on one device. You can count the items together as a team, but make sure the inventory count is being inputted into one single device. Once the inventory count is submitted, your store's inventory levels are updated and you get a report of unexpected variances, including cost figures. On the day before or the day of your inventory count, depending on how much you're counting, you'll need to prepare your inventory, store, and staff. Each store will have a different process for this, but we recommend the following. Checking your barcode scanners to make sure they are functioning. Tidying all areas you'll be counting, including any items on hold, in the back room, or on mannequins. Turning all labels barcode side out for easy scanning. Printing new labels for any products missing labels. Using a floor plan to assign different areas of the store to certain staff members. Marking off areas that have already been counted with a post-it note to ensure that the same areas don't get counted twice. Finally, assigning one senior staff member to conduct an audit partway through to ensure that everyone is on track and each staff member is counting correctly. To get started, navigate to the inventory counts page in your Vend account. From here, you can see the inventory counts that are due, upcoming, completed, or canceled. To schedule a new inventory count or start a new inventory count straight away, click the Add Inventory Count button. First, enter a start date. This will default to today's date and can't be set to a date in the past. Enter time for the inventory count to start. You can set the start date and time for the current date and time, or schedule an inventory count for the future. Select the outlet where the inventory count will take place. Give your account a name. This is something that will tell you what you're counting or why. There are two types of inventory counts, partial counts and full counts. Partial counts are normally for a small section of your inventory, such as particular brand, type, or supplier's items. It's recommended to regularly schedule your partial counts throughout the year. If you're scheduling a partial count, you will find an additional search field. You can filter your search for the brands, types, tags, suppliers, or individual products you need to count. Full count should be completed only when you are required to count your entire outlet stock. If you're completing a full count, all your products will be added to the count and you can just click Start to begin. You'll see a page with the list of all your items to be counted, as well as the expected count for those items. You don't need to count the items in the order they appear on the page. There are a number of ways to count your items. You can scan the barcode of each item. If you're doing this, make sure you tick the Quick Scan Mode box. Quick Scan Mode enables you to rapidly scan each item's barcode in your store to add it to your inventory count. Your scanned item will automatically be counted as soon as you scan the barcode. You can also scan the barcode once and then manually enter the count of every item. Or you can search for an item's name or SKU and then manually enter in the count. If you've made a mistake with your count, there is an easy way to fix this. On the right-hand side of the page, you'll see your most recently counted items. Just click the bin icon to remove that item from your count and reset the count to zero. You can also temporarily stop the count and come back to it later by clicking pause. When you have finished counting or would like to review a count that's in progress, you can click it on the Inventory Counts page and then hit the Review button. Inventory counts can be but do not have to be performed in a linear process. It is perfectly fine to bounce between counting and reviewing what you have done up to that point, as you can always resume the count when you're ready. Here, you can review your counted items. There are 5 tabs you can view. Uncounted lists all items where the total counted quantity is 0. This also includes items with an expected count of 0. Keep in mind that if an item expected to be counted has an expected quantity other than 0, then Vend will update the inventory levels for that product to 0, as it will be treated as missing. Unmatched lists all items that had a count greater or less than the expected amount. This includes items where you expected a negative amount and counted zero. Matched lists all items you've counted where the total counted equals the expected amount. Excluded includes any items you manually excluded from your count. And finally, a review of all your items. You should review all the items in your count, especially the unmatched and uncounted items. If you have discrepancies, you can tick the box next to an item and choose to exclude the item from the count. This means that inventory levels for this item will stay the same as they were before the count began. You can also stop the count from here by clicking the Abandon button. Your inventory levels will not be updated, and a record of this inventory will be saved, but you will no longer be able to edit it. Once the inventory count has been successfully completed, you can see the full results displayed here. This will list your products, the expected amounts, the final counts, the change in units after your count, and any associated cost for that change. You can export the results of this inventory count for your own records to CSV or PDF. If you'd like to look at the cost and quantity in further detail, we recommend exporting a CSV spreadsheet. Exporting by CSV gives you a file with the line for each product counted. You'll also have columns for expected and final count, change in cost, and total value of each product's inventory after count. This is typically used for importing into another accounting system or for creating your own reports.